Bullseye. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, how are you doing today? My name is Kirsten, guys, and today I'm going to be showing you how to use OBS correctly, because some people don't know how to use OBS, and yes, and the first time I got OBS, I was like so frustrated I just deleted it because I didn't know how to use it. Well, let's jump right in. Well, first thing you're going to need to is actually get OBS. Now, don't get this one right here. Wait. Don't get this one. That's lit up. That's, I won't prefer that one. I actually prefer this one, which is the one I actually use right now, is the multi-platform one, which is really simple. Now, since I haven't matured right, the screen's going to go black, so I'm just preparing you for that. So you're going to go ahead and click that, and you're going to save to a folder. Then this is going to download. It's not even a really big download. It's just going to go ahead and download. 1 second, loading. You want to click on that. Here comes the black screen. You want to click yes on the administrator right, see if your computer doesn't. And then it's going to come up to a welcome to OBS multiplatform 0.12.0 setup wizard. You're going to go ahead and click next. I agree. And you're going to click install for that. And then, since I already have it, I'm not going to click install because it's going to mess up my recording. And then click yes, which I think that whole part was black screen, but you're pretty much, if you're listening to this and you're doing it, you pretty much get what I'm trying to say to you. Alright, since now we're back, I'm going to use this file right here, for example. I'm actually moving that so you can see the name of it. And OBS, for example, too. Wow, that's a really bad background name. I really need to change that. Well, first, let's go ahead and open up OBS. Alright. Just right here, it's a recording. It has that like cool little mirror effect when you put something in there. It's really cool and stuff. Anyways, guys, so when you first open up OBS, it's gonna be a black screen. And basically, what you're gonna do to start OBS to show your desktop is gonna go ahead and click on where it says display capture. You're gonna click on display, or it's basically you're gonna put it on your primary monitor. And then you click OK, and to display your cursor, you can do that. And multi-adapter is basically if you have multiple screens. All right, then once that's all set up, that's pretty much how you're gonna get your setups ready for that, for your screen. And all you have to do is just hit start recording. But if you wanna go in more advanced, you go on hit settings, and you wanna do outputs. Going back to that folder that's just an MD4 that says YouTube. Where it says recording path, you can set that to a folder. So I have the folder on desktop, so you can create a folder, and then you just create a folder, hit folder, it says new folder, right? So I actually have to refresh that. All right, and you go to desktop, and it will say new folder, and then you'll click on that, or I have that YouTube folder, and then that's where all your videos will go. So for example, after I'm done with this video, it will go into my Kirsten Sane gaming file, which is right there. Alright, and then once that's all set up, Danny, I'm going to go back to settings. I honestly didn't mean to exit out that. I usually want hotkeys, so to start and stop recording, I do F12 because it's just easier, especially when I'm streaming like Steam games. It captures a picture that I can upload for a thumbnail. And then that's pretty much hotkeys is your options, advanced. Unless you're streaming and you know it and you're a hardcore streamer, you want to be like a hardcore streamer, you can play around with this. Video, I can't really touch, but you honestly get the idea. Your common FPS values, I have it at 30, but if you have a really good game computer, you might want to set that to 45, because your computer can take the stress of more frames being put out. And maybe similar guy, but as long as you're putting out a high frame rate, who really cares, right? Audio, this is where you pick your mic, and unless you have multiple mics to make, I guess, better mic audio, you can do that. And then you got your desktop audio, your mic complex audio, your delay, push to mute, push to talk, delay, and everything. I put my recording format to MP4, and then you want to always keep your recording quality the same as your stream. So my recording format is MP4 for HD 1080 recordings. And that's pretty much it. You got your Steam key, and this is how you do streams live on Twitch, YouTube, Hitbox, Beam Pro, Daily Motion, or Live Recording. Unfortunately, they don't have Ustream. Ustream, you gotta pay. I'm sorry. Guys, and that's pretty much how you'll set up and configure OBS. Really simple with multi-platform form. For me, I just got it like that. I didn't show me. I just got it just by looking around at it. So it should be not that hard for you guys. And that's pretty much it, guys. My name is Kitchen, guys. This is OBS. Make sure you leave a comment, like, and make sure you subscribe, guys. If you have any other questions about this video or asking, can you show me how to do this? I would be glad to make it. Just leave it in the comments. Or you have any questions about I'm having, or if you have any questions about how your problems that you're having OBS, I'll go ahead and answer that for you too, guys. Anyways, that's pretty much it, and that's wrapping up for today, guys. I'm KJ Saint, guys. Until next time, see you next Firefight.